Now, our first guest for today is the brand new Lowkey Records signee, Rose Nkau. She joins us in studio to chat about her musical journey, plus signing under the popular Prince Kaybee.
The talented vocalist hailing all the way from the Northwest Province also performs her single, Take It All, live in studio. But first, let's have a quick look at the video.
Connect with us online if you have any questions for Rose. Tweet us at Afternoon Chat using the official hashtag Afternoon Express or comment on our Facebook page. Rose, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for having me.
You know, what I love about you so much is you just embrace such absolute femininity and sexuality.
Yeah.
So it's so hard to believe that when you were little, they used to try and dress you up as a boy and put you in the boys' choir.
They did, you know. I really did not understand why they would do something like that because, I mean, I look like a girl. But I only got to understand why they put me in the boys' choir just only when I got older and when I realized that I could actually sing.
Yeah.
So I think they saw it in me when I just joined the choir, just a normal choir.
Yeah.
And I think maybe they heard me singing there and then because they usually made us sing like solos just to see who was singing bad.
Wow. That would have always been me.
So they did that and then eventually they got me into the boys' choir. I think maybe it was because they couldn't win or I don't know. But for the first time in the entire decades of their careers or anything, we just won.
And then queen.
My question was, but I actually did not have hair then. I was short haired like
but
now.
But it's great. Yeah.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Absolutely.
It just gives me so much time to think about stuff.
You just get ready and then that's it. It's simple.
Like,
it's all done.
Rose, we're going to definitely try out that voice and hear a little bit of that. Mm-hmm. What made you get into that boys' choir a little bit later? But first and foremost, you had an interesting relationship with academics and music, and then you eventually just had to tilt over to the music side. Mm-hmm. What were the struggles that you went through and what made you decide that music is it?
Okay. I did technical subjects at high school, and I was very good at it. I did engineering, graphics, and design. Mm. I was also good at it. So my mother was like, you're very good at this. Why not just venture into this technical field?
Mm.
And I was like, okay, I can do that, but do we have enough funds for you to send me to school?
Mm.
And then she's like, no, I don't. But then that's when my uncle stepped in and said, you know what, because you're so good, I'll just pay for it. Just come and live with me, and then I'll just pay for everything. I'll take care of you. And then I did. I lived with him and his wife. Mm. They took very good care of me then. I did my electrical, did my N2, my N3, and then dropped out when I did my N4 because I felt that I was not being truthful to myself because I would usually sit there and write songs and I would feel that I need to like sing these songs or perform them or record them. So for me to be able to do that, I need to go out.
Absolutely.
And nobody at home was going to help me with that because they were like, you should go to school.
And also we've come this far to help you in school.
Yeah, you know, and I felt so bad for that, but I eventually said, but if I'm feeling bad, then how long am I going to continue feeling this way?
Mm.
So I just decided, let me just
then what were your steps from there to get discovered? Because I think it's quite difficult for new emerging artists to be heard.
What I did was I actually met up with a lot of musicians and we did gigs here and there, but it was not enough to sustain.
Of course.
To sustain me. So I decided, let me just try out beauty. So went
you were a nail tech once upon a time.
I'm still a nail tech.
Wow.
I'll never leave it. I love it so much. I went to school for that, trained, and then I got my qualification, and I continued doing that. So at least it was able to, like, help me financially to send me to gigs, buy clothes, and be able to also send money home to my family.
But your major huge break happened, of course, when you collaborated with Lowkey Records. How did that collaboration come to be?
Oh my gosh.
And how did Nasty C kind of help you along the way?
It's actually Prince Kaybee.
Prince Kaybee. Prince Kaybee.
I worked with a group called Soul Majestics. Soul Majestic, they're from back home in the Northwest, from Luka.
Okay.
So they are the guys that actually helped me to like record my first songs. So the song that we did was called Redemption Song. We did a rendition of it in a house version. So it actually kind of intrigued a lot of people, but then for it to land on Prince Kaybee's hands was like, oh my gosh, okay. But I did not know that they were going to send that song through to him because he was looking to sign artists.
Okay.
So when he got the song and he listened to it, he felt there's a lot of potential in the song, and then the vocalist behind and the producers as well. So he asked them to give him my number, and then he called me. I really did not believe
what
that.
What is your reaction?
Must have been a fun
time. Oh, Prince Kaybee.
Whatever.
Hello. This is Prince Kaybee. What can I do for you?
How can I help you?
I thought I was being pranked. So prior to the conversation, I felt like, oh, okay, this is actually him. And he was so cool. He was so calm and collected. Yeah. I was like, oh, this is a normal human being.
He's got such a good ear for music, though. So it must be quite inspiring working with him, because he must be quite decisive, I suppose, in the studio with what he's going to work on.
He's very decisive, but I love the fact that he gives us so much freedom to do whatever that we feel is good for the song. And then he'll be able to critique it and show us that, okay, you can do it this way, you can do it that way, let's try it this way. So I just love the fact that he accommodates everybody when we are in studio or when you're in studio with him one-on-one.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Yeah.
Well, you certainly do deserve it. If it's good enough for Kaybee, then it's going to be an astounding performance a little bit later on the show. Make sure to tune in after the break as Dr. Nandipa chats to us about how to care for ethnic skin.